The following six solutions will help you get R Factor 2 up and running again. Solution number 1. Delete the following folder under C. Program Files, x86, Steam Apps Common Factor 2 User Data Player Local Storage and restart R Factor 2. The folder is automatically recreated. Solution number 2. Repair the files of R Factor 2 on Steam. Solution number 3. Run all X files in the R Factor 2 Support Runtimes Files folder. If your problem is related to performance, a good first step is to use Ctrl plus C in-game to activate a small chart that displays two horizontal bars. Firstly, a purple bar that represents physics and should never be close to 100%. This bar shows how much time is spent on physics calculations, performed by the CPU. If this bar behaves erratically and increases to 100%, go to the performance logging section and try to capture the issue with this feature. A green bar representing the graphic should be close to 100%, unless you have limited the frame rate. This bar shows how much time is spent rendering graphics, which is usually done on the GPU. Number 4. Create performance logs. This protocol records how much time RF2 typically spends in which part of the physics code and divides this into different steps, which determines, for example, what the code has done. Physics is frozen, such as calculating player physics, performing collisions, communicating with the steering wheel, within plugins, etc. How do I enable the protocol? Open the player JSON file, located in User Data Player, with a text editor and look for the line where real-time logging 0 and change it to real-time logging 1. Performance logs end up in the User Data Log folder of your R Factor 2 installation. The last 5 sessions are always saved. Should be 2 files per session, named after the session and ending with the extension .csv. If the files are large, you can zip them. 5. Graphics logging records how much time R Factor 2 typically spends on which part of the graphics code. The frame time, equals time for rendering a single image, is divided into different steps, e.g. shadow drawing, reflection calculation, etc. To activate the protocol, make sure you sit and drive in your car. Press Ctrl plus F to activate the frame rate information in the upper left corner. Left shift plus space bar to start recording. The message, recording, should appear on the screen. Recording continues for some time and then stops again. What do you want to send? Graphics logs end up in the User Data Log folder of your R Factor 2 installation. Sort the files by modification date. All these logs start with perf log and end with .txt. Send us this text file along with a description of the problem. If you have an in-game time, feel free to specify it. If they are large, you are welcome to zip them. Solution number 6. Send mini dump file. A mini dump file exports information that can tell us why the game crashed and that can be helpful in finding problems. Where can I find it? You can find the file in Steam Apps Common Factor 2 User Data. The file is named rfmini.dmp. Make sure it was created at the same time as the crash. Finally, upload the files via the official Discord channel of R Factor 2 under the title Support. There is 24 hours 7 days at least one developer online who will help you.